a kayak paddles across Big Bayou. We head north past downtown St. Petersburg on our way to Coffee Pot Bayou. Coffee Pot Bayou is ringed by some of St. Petersburg's most expensive houses. The bridge connects Snell Isle with the old northeast section. Lots of birds nest on this mangrove island in Coffee Pot Bayou. This is the downtown St. Petersburg skyline. And the city's new municipal pier. There were more boats than usual sailing around the bay. These boats anchored right off the beach at Lassing Park. The homes around Big Bayou are more modest, but they're gradually being replaced by larger ones. As Anne tried to get a close-up shot of this great blue heron, he kept retreating until he ran out of dock. One windy afternoon, we had exceptionally high tide and a southeast wind. Occasionally, little waves would splash through the dock from underneath. It's much cooler sailing at night, and the downtown city lights are spectacular. Coming into Bayboro Harbor, turning left at the seawall takes you into Salt Creek. Salt Creek is lined with boat slips, a high and dry marina, and several boat yards. The creek is navigable only as far as 3rd Street. Some of the boat yards are capable of handling quite large vessels. Turning right at the seawall takes you into a basin shared by the University of South Florida and the Harbor Ridge Marina. The outer part of the harbor is home to the Coast Guard base and the city's cruise ship terminal. This mangrove island is just across from the launch ramps at Grandview Park. On the kayak, I usually detour through the park on my way to Little Bayou. This is the first of two bridges to Coquina Key. They are at either end of Bonita Bayou. Just south of the second Coquina Key Bridge, this canal leads to Little Bayou.